It is evident everywhere I go in Vietnam that the American fighting man of this war is the best trained soldier we have ever put into the field. I say this not only because he outfights the enemy or because he is tougher and stronger and smarter. He is all of these things. But today's American soldier is something more. He is a thoughtful man, disciplined in restraint of fire as well as in its accuracy. He can fight with ferocity and skill when the Viet Cong will fight. But he will resist provocation and make sure of his target before he shoots. He can enter a village from which he has been fired upon, destroy or rout the Viet Cong, and then show compassion for the families left behind. Never before have we asked so much of our soldiers, and it is a credit to our training base in the United States that he, the American soldier, meets these new demands. I congratulate and thank the officers and men of the Continental Army Command, the training centers and the service schools, the drill sergeants, the military instructors, unit commanders, and the planners may all be proud of their products. They have the unqualified admiration of this command.